your own family and your future. Just horribly sad. And so needless. And you come to the court, you come to this case with no criminal record whatsoever. Seldom that I see someone facing such legal problems and have no prior record. No doubt in my mind that you would, if you could, change things and change what happened and change what you did that day and the events leading up to it. But you can't. And I looked at the map. I'm familiar with that road, and I imagine during that time of day that your car, even if you weren't conscious, or could have veered off into, it's an unpopulated area, it's a wide road, for your car to strike exactly where it struck, there could not have been worse luck than what we have in this case. Worse or more tragic results. So, Ms. Ruggs suffered and died. Mr. Oliphant, sounds like he may and has been just a shell for himself. Ms. McCants, I saw her walk in here to testify. Significant injuries. So, all around, this is a terribly, terribly tragic case. There are no easy answers. But without question, impact on the victims and their families and the loved ones is significant. Ms. Schuster, you're convicted in count one of aggravated vehicular homicide, felony of the second degree. In my mind, whatever the worst form of the offense is, you've committed that. And that goes with respect to counts 1, 3, and 5. And the court sent you to 8 years in the Ohio Department of Rehabilitation and Corrections. It would be a mandatory sentence by law. Court will impose a lifetime driver's license suspension. You're also convicted of count 3, aggravated vehicular assault. This, of course, involved the injuries of Mr. Oliphant. Court will sentence you to 60 months in the Ohio Department of Rehabilitation and Corrections. That is also a mandatory sentence. That sentence will be served consecutive to the sentence imposed in count 1. quarter wall and post relative to count three. A driver's license suspension. 10 years, and of course that will run concurrent with driver's license suspension opposed to count one. The driver's license suspensions imposed in these cases will all begin April 22nd, 2015. In count five, ma'am, you were convicted of aggravated vehicular assault. This involved the injuries to Tiffany McCants. Court will impose 36 months in the Ohio Department of Rehabilitation and Corrections. It's a mandatory sentence that will run consecutive to the sentences imposed in counts one and three. We'll impose a 10-year driver's license suspension concurrent to the suspensions imposed in counts one and three. With respect to your conviction, count seven, this involved the injuries to Billy Moore. The court will impose a mandatory sentence of 36 months. That sentence will run concurrent to the sentence imposed in count five. That also is a mandatory sentence. Court will also impose a driver's license suspension of 10 years. That will run concurrent with the other driver's license suspensions. Count nine, you're convicted of operating a motor vehicle under the influence. It's a misdemeanor of the first degree. Court will impose a six-month jail sentence, 3 days of which is mandatory. That sentence will run concurrent with counts one, three, five, seven. Impose a driver's license suspension of 3 years concurrent with the other driver's license suspensions. The court will also impose a fine of $375. You're also ordered to pay the court costs associated with this case. You'll receive credit for time served in the amount of 52 days. Upon your release from prison, you'll be subjected to a mandatory 3-year period of post-release control. If you violate the post-release control sanctions, verbal verdict can return you to prison and require that you serve more time in prison, up to one half of your original sentence, on one of the post-release control violations. The court has considered your financial resources, your ability to pay financial sanctions both now and in the future. Right to appeal your conviction, the right to appeal the sentence that has been imposed. In order to preserve your appellate rights, you must file your notice of appeal in 30 days. If you are indigent, you have the right to have an attorney appointed to represent you. You have the appeal filed at the payment of court cost, and have any documents necessary for your appeal provided to you without cost. Court would like to make clear that the presumption that exists in the law with respect to current sentences has been rebutted.
Thank you.
Been rebutted in this case. The court will find that the imposition of consecutive sentences is necessary to adequately protect the public and to punish you and are not disproportionate. We'll find consecutive terms are necessary because the harm is so great or unusual that a single term does not adequately reflect the seriousness of your conduct. Counsel has requested an appellate bond. The court's not inclined to deny the request for an appellate bond. If you would like to file a formal motion and an entry so you have a record for the Court of Appeals, feel free to file that and bring it to my attention. All right. Now, Ms. Schuster, you'll be held in Butler County Jail until you can be transported to prison. Are there any questions regarding this sentence?
Counsel, has a question if I could approach. I have a question. Yes.
Yes.